Hey guys, welcome to this project slash DIY SRC motor speed controller. A neighbor of mine who is in the honey extraction business asked me if I could repair his motor speed controller that was no longer working. So I decided to have a look and also share the experience with you guys. If you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to Syntech channel. That would be highly appreciated. I thank you. I opened it up and I found out there was some burnt into the strip board, and there was a one resistor here that I took off and I replaced it with a similar resistor. So it's the main resistor that is dissipating most of the power, and that's for the current that the driver is drawing. Okay, so as soon as I replaced the resistor, the driver was working. I was able to connect the motor and control the speed, but I did disconnect the fuse. There is a fuse here. This is a fuse holder. I disconnected it and the main switch. So I just wanted to power it straightforward, and also some of the wires were also not connected at all. So I needed to reroute. So I needed to go through the circuit and make sure that the circuit was still in good working condition. Okay, so after getting everything right, I was able to then this thing run and control the speed of the motor, as I'm going to show you guys right now. I would connect it to the motor and we'll see how this thing will be controlling the speed of the motor. So the main chip in this board here is the L120A. It's a bit difficult to read in there. I'm not sure if we can zoom in there and read in there. All right, I'm not sure if we can read in there, but the chip is the linear integrated circuit L120A. Now I looked up the part number. I find the following data sheet, which is L120A, the marking code on the IC. So it is a linear integrated circuit. As you can see, it's a TRIAC SRC phase controller. According to the data sheet, it operates with an AC supply of 50 to 60 Hertz, and it has a zero voltage and zero current detector. So that's basically a zero crossing pins that it can detect. So that's actually what's allow it to have that functionality of a TRIAC controller, RAM generator, and so forth. Okay, these are the absolute maximum rating for the chip, and we're not going to go through these right now. We can go through it when we get to the design of the circuit itself. But when we scroll, it's the package. It's a DIP package, 16 pin. Okay, and when we go all the way down, I find this circuit, which is a test circuit. Now, the circuit that is wired into this box here, into this Vero board, is basically almost the same one as this one on the test circuit. Okay, so when I'm gonna make a new circuit, I can basically just copy this one here. Going in through the wiring in this one here, there is one or two elements that was added here, and I'm going to find out what they were for. But basically, this test circuit stipulate that this is for any load. You can control even a light bulb with this test circuit. And if you go again down into your data sheet, these are some of the characteristics of the device. Right here, we have another test circuit, and this one says it's an application circuit for AC motor speed control, speed regulators. Okay, so now this circuit is a little bit more sophisticated, because we have an AC tachometer here, which is basically, if you see, this is a load, that's your motor. Now the tachometer is connected on the shaft of your motor, so it's reading your speed directly into the shaft of the motor. And because, you know, if the motor is running freely with no load, it's gonna run much faster. But if you put a load on it, the speed is sort of gonna slow down. So if, yeah, so the tachometer is going to read that speed and feed it back with a voltage. So there is a small rectifier that's going to rectify based on the voltage that is generated here, and it's going to feed it back into pin 3. And that pin 3, it's going to do some magic in the IC and feed it back into this control divider here that's feeding into the SRC. So that's basically how the feedback circuit works. But the one that I'm going to remake, I want to have the tachometer circuit wired because I don't have it. So I will just redraw the schematic simply without the tachometer, and hopefully you can get a smooth enough running control. Okay, and neat, clean, safe, and that's going to be very different from what we see in front of us here, because this really, no wonder why it's failed, because the circuit doesn't really meet the standard. So we're gonna try to make it much better. Okay, so yeah, that is it. So you can also use the chip for a power supply. I can see an adjustable power supply, regulator, and so forth, but that's not the subject of this tutorial / DIY motor control driver. But okay, I'm going to connect it into the universal motor that I have, and we're going to see how we can control the speed with the circuit that I know is working before I demolish it and build another circuit with the same component in a much cleaner, proper PCB. Okay, so let's get going. Okay guys, as you can see, I have connected the motor driver, and this is connected straight onto the mains, and it is really rather very dangerous. So there is no isolation, so you have to be careful if you're going to do these kind of things. Okay, so as we can see, the control is this potentiometer here. By increasing the speed, we can increase the speed of the motor. So we can control the speed of the motor by controlling the potentiometer value. Now, by changing the settings on the potentiometer, we can vary the voltage, and that is feeding into our motor control driver, and we can then control the speed by changing the phase control. So that is basically it. And the wires here, these are the forward reverse wires. They are connected, basically four wires. Now the four wires are the field wires and the armature wires. Now by using this double pole double throw switch, we can then switch the sides. So we either change the connection of the field to the armature. So basically by switching the connection, you can change the direction of the motor. As you can see, I can try like this. As you can see there, the directions of rotation have changed. I can switch back, the directions of rotations have again changed. Now there is a nameplate on the universal motor, but they haven't illustrated the power rating. Now we only know that it's universal, it can be driven by both DC and AC, but there is no power rating. Now the nameplate says that it's a universal motor. It operates on 50 Hertz, but there is unfortunately no power rating. We can see at the bottom there, it's 220 volt AC. Okay, so that's basically it. But it is quite a very powerful motor, as we can hear by increasing the speed. The table where I've mounted it here, is everything is shaking. So this is a very, very powerful motor. You can see this is a very powerful motor. As I increase the speed of the motor, you can see the motor speed have increased, and it's quite a very powerful motor. Okay, so that is it. So then as we have already said, I'm going to change this circuitry here and make it a much neater board, and then build it up again and test it again. Hopefully we're not going to damage it also. So stay tuned for the next tutorial. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe to SimTech channel. Thank you. Cheers.